webinar, and I will be sending out the recording and the presentation at the end of the webinar, all the contact information for all of our panelists today. And just to start off, a little introduction about everybody. Don, I'm going to go ahead and let you introduce yourself and Acumatica, since it's the umbrella ERP we're focusing on.
Absolutely. Thank you. Hopefully everybody can hear me all right. I am Don Jaeger, Director of Partner Recruiting for Acumatica. And I have to thank everybody for attending. I see a number of partners, a number of new partners that are brand new with Acumatica. And I also see several people that are considering Acumatica partnership. So thank you for joining. I think it's a great overview and introduce you to a wide variety of our ISV solutions that help extend the product. As many of you may already know, we're a true cloud ERP solution that is developed specifically for mid-market customers. We really play well in companies that do distribution, manufacturing, services, retail and e-commerce, and a whole wide variety of other customer types. I think our claim to fame is that we're 100% channel only, so exceedingly partner friendly. We're very competitive in the mid-market space, and we have some real advantages, like you can deploy Acumatica wherever you want, in our cloud, any other cloud, on-prem. You can invest in Acumatica either through subscription or an actual purchase. And we have so many other things that are key differentiators versus our competitors. So we're excited to tell you more about it today. And thanks to our beloved ISV partners for doing this with us today. Thank you.
Thanks so much, Don. Great introduction. And we have Artsel. Artsel was established in 2002, 50 plus employees. They take the pain out of sales order process and automating all the error prone tasks that when you're manually processing document management into Acumatica. They rely on their Dalk Alpha business digitization platform and order action application. So they transform scanned paper and digital orders into actionable information. So it has a shorter cycle with fewer errors and better process control for an improved overall customer experience. We have Scanco with us. Scanco is a leader in warehouse management applications. They've been serving the mid-market since 1989, and they meet the needs of thousands of distribution and manufacturing companies. They have a WMS application, warehouse management service application, that is available on iOS, Android, and Windows devices, so that those warehouse personnel can go out in the warehouse and do all their picking and packing processes automatically, so that information code can go right back into Acumatica. We have Starship with us. Starship's a gold FedEx compatible solution provider and a strategic UPS ready partner. They have a wide range of carriers available in their platform to automate the shipping process. And they launched their Acumatica interface in 2016, and they are market leaders in the Sage and Microsoft Dynamics channels as well. We also have APS with us, American Payment Solutions. They are a leading merchant solutions provider. They have the ability to get the lowest rates through level 3 credit card processing by using all that customer data in Acumatica. They serve large, medium, and small organizations. And we're just going to talk a little bit about the workflow here. So orders or documents can come in via email, phone, fax, scanner, paper can just come right in. Artsel will digitize that paper and place all that information into Acumatica. And Scanco will take that information, if it's an order, and pick and pack it, automate all the picking and packing processes, and put all the information back into Acumatica, where Starship can pick the ideal carrier based on all the information of the shipment, the dimensional weight, the customer location, all the best rules of the shipment based on what the customer defines, and pick the ideal carrier to deliver the customer's expectations. And if credit card processing is the preferred payment for that accounts receivable invoice that Starship now updates in Acumatica, American Payment Solutions can process that transaction through level 3 credit card processing to get the best rates. They're experts in credit card processing, so we recommend that you contact them for any credit card processing needs. And with that said, I'm going to go ahead and pass it along to Bosco for Artzel.
Okay, well, thank you very much. I'm pleased to be on this call. We're going to talk about Artzel and its value proposition. Our solution is based on a platform called Doc Alpha, which is an advanced capture and OC and very powerful OCR, optical character recognition platform. With Acumatica specifically, we are an ISV, level 2 ISV, and so we've got some very powerful integrations with the Acumatica platform. On my screen, you'll see sort of a very high-level architectural overview of our Acumatica integration solution. Essentially, we have the ability to ingest documents from literally any source, whether they be emails, paper scans, fax server integrations, folder watch, EDI, whatever the source of those transactions are, we're able to process them through Doc Alpha. We refer to that as multi-channel capture. And then we perform automated document classification, separation, and extraction of documents. From a value proposition, this simply means that we can ingest multiple document types all in one batch. There's no need for any manual preparation or separation of single versus multi-page documents, separating invoices from purchase orders, from checks and credit notes, et cetera. Application does all of that in an automated and unattended fashion. And then we apply very powerful optical character, as well as optionally handwriting recognition. So that's not a problem. If certain purchase orders may come handwritten, we can apply technology to detect that. And then very simply, we apply some very powerful automated rules, lookups and so on. So in the case of a sales order, if you have a quote-based system, we can actually do a lookup and reference that quote when we're capturing the details from the sales order, which you'll see in my demonstration. And then very simply, we have a workflow that allows an operator to review the results of the recognition and extraction and perform various functions. You also see on my screen an AP process, which is sort of the second process following the purchase order. So the same platform has the ability to not just simply do sales order recognition, but also do AP automation and then take the corresponding invoices and match them to the POs that were originally captured and stored into Acumatica. So once again, we have very, very powerful levels of integration with the Acumatica platform. So with that said, I'm now going to run a quick demonstration of our solution, which is called order action, as well as invoice action for invoice processing. As I mentioned, both are built on the same platform. So you're going to see both aspects in this one demonstration. On my screen here, you see three different document types. One is an invoice, the one I've just highlighted. There's a check in there, and more importantly, there's a purchase order, which has got some line item detail, which is obviously one of the value propositions that we bring to the table in terms of being able to capture not just the relevant information, but all the line item details. So to simulate the capture process, I'm simply going to copy these documents over into my hot folder and paste them in. So here I'm sort of simulating a process where Doc Alpha is monitoring email accounts, fax servers, paper scans that are arriving in a destination, and in an automatic and unattended fashion, we are capturing these documents and processing them. So from a manual perspective, we're eliminating a lot of the manual separation and so on that's required typically in a manual process. Once Doc Alpha has received these documents, they go through a process that I'll show you. This is a background process, and you'll notice very quickly the documents have arrived for what's called the verification process. I'm now going to bring the document that you saw me scan into this window called the verification window. And you'll see very shortly that Doc Alpha immediately recognized that one document was an invoice and has classified it as an invoice. It saw a check and did extraction based on the check, but most importantly for the purchase order, it was able to capture all the detail that was specified that was required to be captured. In this case, we're capturing the numbers, the phone number, the currency. So we're doing automatic currency detection, which is a very powerful aspect of this application. The requested dates, and we're capturing the line item detail as well, as you can see as I go through the different fields or metadata that's required by Acumatica. We're capturing all these fields in a very powerful and automated fashion. On the right, you see the image that has been optical OCR'd, and you'll notice that as I hover over any fields here, I have the ability to capture other information that you may need as part of your workflow downstream from our capture process. So delivery terms, revision dates, fax numbers, and most importantly, we can go into the line item detail and you'll see we've captured everything in a very, very powerful and automated fashion. So just once again, I wanted to emphasize that the same platform is not only doing sales order processing, but when the corresponding invoice might come along, we're also able to perform automatic extraction of invoice details at the line item level, as well as the header and footer, and process the documents against Acumatica. So once the purchase order has been processed and posted into Acumatica, the next logical step would be the invoice comes along. What I'm doing here is very quickly, the application is simply verifying that everything has been captured correctly in terms of the character recognition, making sure that all the data is 100% correct based on a confidence level where we say, if something is less than, let's say 80% accurate, then just simply report it as an exception so that I know that the data that's been captured from my purchase order in this example here is 100% accurate. So once I've done that, you'll notice that there's a green checkbox against each of these documents on my top left. That means I'm now ready to post them directly to Acumatica. One last thing that I quickly want to explain here is, you will recall I mentioned that once we've processed the purchase order, when the corresponding invoice comes along, and we capture it in the same process. In this example here, I'm showing you that we've captured the line item detail, and now we're validating this information directly against the purchase order in Acumatica to ensure that this is 100% accurate. One quick example of a validation rule that I'll demonstrate before I wrap this demonstration here is, if I attempt to change this amount, let's say to 35, and it was misrecognized, you'll notice that two things have happened. One is, I reported that there's a mismatch against the lookup inside of Acumatica where the quantity on invoice does not match the database value that was on the purchase order as well as the delivery steps. So it's a very, very high level, powerful integration with the backend Acumatica ERP application. I'll correct that, make it 36. And you'll also notice that before I correct that, we're doing some very powerful validation in terms of arithmetic. So we're applying math of quantity times price to equal the total to again validate that this information going in is 100% correct. That math is also applicable if I had configured it on the purchase order as well. So with that said, once I'm done with this entire process, and I know I'm reaching the end of my time here, we simply click on the green bar here, which is the export, and then these documents are now released to Acumatica after I finish my validation process. So just to wrap, I'll switch back here to our PowerPoint slide and explain that what you saw briefly was a capture process that came from a scan or an email attachment, went through our application. Doc Alpha did the automatic recognition of a purchase order versus an invoice. It did all the extraction of the relevant fields within the purchase order, did the validation to make sure everything was correct, applied all the business rules, and then posted the purchase orders directly to the platform. And then when the corresponding invoice came along, it was able to match that invoice to the purchase order. With that, I will hand over to the next panelist.
Thank you, Bosco. Richard, thank you so much.
No problem. Let me make sure I'm on the correct screen here. Show screen. Monitor 2. There we go. Okay. Hi, everybody. My name is Richard Kurtzer. I am the Acumatica practice / sales lead at ScanCo. So we're going to talk a little bit about our warehouse product today, and I decided to scrap the usual LinkedIn-style photo for something a little bit more natural. Just a little bit about ScanCo. We've been around since 1989 and been focused on serving the mid-market for barcoding and data collection. So we have a long history on many other ERP platforms such as Sage, and now we are moving rather strongly into Acumatica. Our user base is growing all the time, and we have a couple exciting products, namely warehouse management and then also manufacturing management. Since today we're a little bit time limited, we're just going to focus on warehouse management, but if you have any questions on our manufacturing product, which interfaces with JANS, feel free to reach out. So ScanCo Warehouse for Acumatica. What we do is we basically take the standard transactions in Acumatica and we put them on the handheld. We let you do them in the warehouse live, no lag time, no nothing. And it covers receiving, location transfers, warehouse transfers, fulfillment, physical counts, bin management, location visibility, and then importantly, it stays up to date. Because as you know, with Acumatica, you have a pure cloud application, you have a regular schedule of updates, and we stay right in lockstep with that and keep our application up to date. So it's always going to work with the version that you're running. A little bit about the hardware that I'm going to show you today. I'm going to be showing you a live mirror off of an iPhone that's mounted in one of these little Cognex housings. That gives me the hardware barcoding scanner that I'll need to run the system. Just a little bit more about what we're doing here. One of the most important things I'm going to show you now, as I break out of PowerPoint here, is a nice, clean user interface. I'm going to bring my Acumatica up in the background here. So one of the biggest things with warehouse, you know, why do companies want to do it? They're looking for ease of use, ease of training, and they want people to get up to speed with it and use it efficiently so you eventually get that return on investment. And that's a lot of what we were talking about on the invitation to that. So I'll be spending quite a bit of time on the count. But let's start off with purchase order receiving. And I'm going to be using a mixture of doing lookups and also using live barcodes here. So we have my main transactions here, inventory, physical count, sales order, purchase order. But let's start with the purchase order and follow this order from start to finish. So I'm going to do a receipt by order. All right, so there's a couple ways I can get that purchase order number in there. I can either look it up or I can grab it off of a barcode. And since I do have barcodes, I'm just going to grab that barcode there. And that's going to give me a data validation error because there's nothing left on that purchase order. So I'm going to grab a different one. See, if you look over here, when I do a lookup on that purchase order, it's highlighted in red and I can't receive anything against it. So let's clear that out and look at what I got here. So if you look at my screen, this is a list of the open purchase orders that I have in my system. And I'm going to go ahead and grab the second one here, number 252. Once that purchase order, again, is open, I can either look up or scan the part numbers. Now, since I don't have an order sheet or anything like that, I'm going to go ahead and do a lookup for this PO. And it looks like I can't receive anything against this one. Let's go grab one more. Again, grab the purchase order number, do a lookup. Alrighty, now you can see these are the items that I can receive on this purchase order. I have flour, a premix flavor, and water. So let's go ahead and receive my flour. Once I populate the item, it's also going to give me which line it is, the unit of measure, and then I'm going to have to pick a bin number in which to receive it. So let's receive that into row one, shelf one. That's where I have my other flour. And I'm going to receive 5 because I have 5 left on the order. 5 have showed up on my warehouse door, and that's what I want to receive. A couple different steps I can do right now. I can keep going, keep receiving POs, and then what I can do right now is just send it up to Acumatica, and I'm looking at my time, so I'm going to speed up a little bit here so we can get into the count workflow. But if I go back into my purchase orders on Acumatica and take a look at number 342 here, let's just look that up. Guess this one got purged out on the other end. All right, I'll come back to that. Let's go and ship a sales order here. So I'm going to ship a sales order by order number. Let's go ahead and grab this number right here. So there I've got my sales order. And let's grab the first item on that. Yeah, no quantity left on that one. So let's go ahead and look that up. All right, so you can see that I've shipped my Legos and my Powerade. And now I can ship my Pogo Stick and my Little Tykes baby chair. So let's ship the baby chairs. Pick the bin number that I'm going to grab them out of. All right, you can see that the bins that have no stock are highlighted in red, and the ones that I do have stock on are going to be in black there. So I'm going to go from row one, shelf one. And you can see it's unit of measure eaches. There's my bin. I don't have to scan eaches in this case, and I'm going to ship 20 units. A couple things I can do here. I can send it up to Acumatica, or I can hit this review button up here and take a look at what that transaction was. And I can either delete that or send that right up to Acumatica. So I'm going to go ahead and send this one. If I go back into Acumatica, sales order, and look up order number 3419. Alrighty. You see my shipment that I just performed right there on the handheld. It's in Acumatica essentially instantly. So as we roll forward, that covers that. Now, physical counting is important, and we decided to highlight that because that's a lot of the return on investment that you get on a warehouse management system is going to come from eliminating all that inventory variance and reducing the amount of time that you have to spend counting stuff. So basically, we let you take the counts that you set up in Acumatica and bring them into the handheld. So I have my count in progress here. Let's go back to my handheld here. And this is a count that you set up in Acumatica. So I go over to my physical count menu. I'm going to go by item. And let's see, if I hit return here, this is going to bring up my active counts. I'm in count number 15. All right, and I'm operating in my wholesale warehouse. And let's pick an item. All right, I'm going to start with my Powerade for a very specific reason. So I have my Powerade, it's in inches, and let's look at which bin number I actually want to count in. I'm going to count the items that I have at the counter. Now, with this item, it is a lot controlled item, so I either have to enter in or scan the lot number. So I'm going to go ahead and scan that. And I have 14 of them on the shelf here. Done. And that's completed. If I want to continue on this item, I can enter in another lot number and repeat the process over and over again until I have everything counted. But since this is all the Powerade I have in this bin, I'm going to go ahead and send it up to Acumatica. And if I refresh this item, there we go, entered. There's my third line right there, AA Powerade, my lot and serial, the expiration date shown, book quantity, physical quantity, no variance. Let's do one more transaction, physical count by item, show you a different item. Let's go back into my count number, count C. Now let's count the Legos. All right, so this one I'm doing because the Legos are not controlled by lot and serial number. Just wanted to show you what it looks like. It's a little different here. Let me pull this back up here. Sorry about that. So I'm going to step back here. Physical count by item. Open up the count number 15. And I'm going to scan my part number. All right, let's go to my counter bin because that's what I'm counting right now. All right, how many do I have in stock? I have 65 on the shelf right here. I've counted them. Done. Now that data saved successfully, but I'm going to use this one to show you exactly how the review process works. So I can hit that review button up top and it'll show me all of my pending actions before I send them up to Acumatica. So I could do 1, 2, 5, 10, however many transactions I want on the handheld. And then I can send and it'll send them all up to Acumatica. If I made a data entry error, like when I'm counting, I counted 14 instead of 15 and I catch myself, I can fix it there and delete it. So that's what I'm going to do here. I'm going to hit action and delete that transaction. Now, once we've done our physical count, everything's going to be done in here. You can then adjust your inventory variances, do your counts, make any adjustments that you need in Acumatica. And on my end, once we're done with purchase order receiving, and then we've shipped out something on a sales order, things are actually going to flow through and ship out through, through Starship. So that basically covers everything that I wanted to show today, and I'm going to turn it over.
Awesome. Thanks. This is Caroline from V Technologies. I'm going to be showing you Starship today. Starship is a multi-carrier, multi-mode shipping application that integrates directly into the Acumatica ERP solution. We have a very similar story as the Scanco guys. We've been in business since 89 with the key niche of integrating shipping into ERP systems. So we're happy to present the Acumatica interface today. So once the shipment has been defined using the handhelds, you can really go into Starship, scan that shipment number in. Starship will go out to Acumatica, bring in the information, translate data, and get you ready to ship. So when we bring this information in, we're bringing in the header level information, we're translating the ship via here, we're bringing in that recipient, validating the address if you need that. On the shipment aspect, carrier service, billing type can also be translated for you. You can hold accounts from within Starship. You can bring those in through Acumatica, lots of options there. In this particular case, you'll see that I have my QuantumView Notify, so this is UPS's email notification. I only have this set to the exception, though, because I just want to notify us and or the salesperson if the shipment isn't going to be there, so I can proactively call the customer and let them and notify them of the issues with their shipment. In this instance, we're also going to have Starship generate the outbound email. So Starship can generate this in real time, can give you the ability to brand the email, to add Acumatica contents to the body of the email. So you have a lot of flexibility there. Also, insurance here is going to be selected because that's coming over from the flag on the shipping options within Acumatica. I can rate shop this, or I can just leave this as the carrier and service that's been translated from the shipment. Starship also has ship via rules where it can automatically determine the carrier and service based on best method, based on your parameters that you've configured in Starship. So all I really need to do at this point is to click ship and process here or F5. Starship's going to communicate out to the carrier, generate the barcoded shipping labels, and then update Acumatica accordingly. This information, when we send out the connection over to the carriers, it's actually going out and getting your negotiated rates to write back into Acumatica. So we're using your credentials and actively connecting to the carrier servers on the back end. As I mentioned earlier, Starship supports both the small package that I'm showing you today, as well as around 24 LTL carriers. So we can also access pro numbers and generate pallet labels as well. This is an example of our smart label. It's a combination packing list plus shipping label. And this example I'm bringing up as an 8.5 by 11. So it's coming up with this little die cut area for your 4 by 6. Both of these can be printed to a thermal label printer if you want the packing list to print to a 4 by 6, 7 or 8 inch label. So that was my one of one box here. It has the item level information, ordered and shipped. The shipped quantity here is going to be defined on the Scanco handhelds. So really nothing has to be done on the shipping part. And then I'm ready to process my next shipment. So it's pretty simple. What I wanted to do is to go back into Acumatica and bring up that shipment so we could show you how that was updated. Let's find that guy. So here's the shipment that we processed. A couple of things here. We're going to add package level information. So we processed one package here, tracking numbers, the reference I have set to be the carrier and service method, so you can easily see it from this packaging screen. You have control over the information that actually gets updated here. So there's some reverse translations that also happen on the box ID. It's all configurable within Starship. We're also updating the image here. So if you needed to somehow grab, for some reason, grab this label image, you could do that directly from the Acumatica screen. Other things that are going to be updated on the shipment settings, we're going to update the freight cost and the freight amount. In this case, I'm actually charging my customer my rate. If I was had any freight rules or anything else associated to this where Starship's automatically calculating a freight amount that's going to be billed to your customer or to the recipient that's different from my actual cost, that amount would be shown here. And then the status is going to be updated to confirmed if you want it to do that, so it can update the and make that process and workflow faster, as well as the notes information can be updated for you. The other thing that I wanted to show you really quick before we go on is the email notification. A lot of customers like to use this because it's going to allow you to put your own branding here. You can use it as a marketing tool if you'd like to bring people back to your website with some promo offers. You do have the ability to create as many templates as you want. So for example, I had another template here that had a different image in it. And you can actually define when the template is used. So if you want to offer different promo codes for different customers or under different circumstances, you can do that all within Starship. With that, I'm going to pass it over to Patty so she can talk about charging your customer and getting credit card processing going after you've processed the shipment.
Thank you, Caroline. And ladies and gentlemen, thank you once again for allowing us to present our solutions to you this afternoon. We hope the information that we're providing has been helpful so far. I do want to point out the fact that the solutions being presented today will not only give you automation and validation, but also security, compliance, and then the add-on functionality of getting paid faster. I'd like to just briefly begin by setting a foundation. Typically, as a credit card processor, it's more of our job to teach people how to understand that how the charges are being presented in their statements. Something along the lines of who makes the money where the fees are coming from exactly, and how much your processor should actually be charging you. Where can you save money? And we typically begin by explaining the different fee structures. You can see on the screen I have the flat rates that are available, tiered pricing, and then Interchange Plus. The reason that we like to go over the different rate structures is because this is where you would find the highest level of savings. Most of our merchants come from other processors that recommend flat rates. A flat rate is something that is very easily understood, which is the reason most merchants like to go ahead and sign flat rate contracts. The disadvantage here is that the card brands will sometimes offer programs that will lower rates in half and sometimes even lower than half, simply by providing them with a certain criteria that I'll explain in a few seconds. If you signed a flat rate contract, you are not going to be able to take advantage of any of those programs. And guess who gets to keep the money being saved? Your processor. The tiered pricing. Some merchants would like it because they negotiate different rates based on qualifying the transactions. However, the criteria for qualifying the transaction remains up to the processor's discretion. So what we see most often when tiered pricing is in place are the non-qualified transactions, which of course mean higher rates. Now the third fee structure is Interchange Plus. This is by far the most transparent fee structure. Why? Because you actually get the cost from the card brand transferred directly to the merchant and then negotiate a specific rate, markup fee, or transaction fee with your processor. So this is transparent. The processor will tell you exactly how much they're going to be making off of your account. So one of the questions we typically get with Acumatica users is, why not just authorize.net? I'm getting really good rates. Why would I want to switch to another processor? And I've tried to outline it in a visual format for you. There are fees involved, but I think the fees are not as important as the integration to Acumatica itself. And then as an added bonus, Level 3 processing is completely available and integrated, automated, if you're using your Acumatica integration. And I'll explain what Level 3 processing is. Level 3 processing is a program that was put in place by Visa and MasterCard around 2008. It basically offers to cut rates in half for any U.S.-based company that processes business-to-business or business-to-government transactions. So if you're accepting a corporate card or a government card and you deliver a certain amount of criteria, Visa and MasterCard will cut the rate in half for you. We've seen the rates go down to 0.03%, depending on the volume of an account. The required fields you can see on the screen right now are multiple fields. All of these fields are available out of the box from Acumatica. So if you're processing your credit card transactions within Acumatica, we will take these fields and deliver them to Visa and MasterCard on your behalf, therefore guaranteeing the very lowest rates available in the industry. And I can tell you, we can save customers an average of $20,000 to $112,000 per year. So please keep that in mind. Now, what are some of the challenges that are reported by many merchants that process through American Payment Solutions now officially switched off of their current processor? Number one, very confusing merchant statements. Well, here's our promise to all of our merchants. We will help you decipher your current merchant statements and then offer you the most transparent merchant statements available in the industry. We will have you understand where the fees are coming from, who's making the money where, and how much exactly American Payment Solutions will make off of your account. We guarantee our rates in writing. So this is something that not too many processors will do. They will guarantee the very lowest rates to get you to switch, and then they will slowly but surely start creeping up the rates down the line. We offer free PCI support. Now here's what we have seen multiple times in many statements. There is a $35 per month fee and a $75 per year fee to help you remain PCI compliant. With us, you do not have to worry about maintaining your PCI compliance because we will walk you through the entire process from start to finish, and we will have our dedicated team either make sure you become PCI compliant or remain PCI compliant. The benefits of level three. Not too many processors are able to offer them, and if they do, they will ask you to key in level three information every time you process a transaction. This is where we're very different. Because of our integration with Acumatica, we will not ask you to key anything in, and we will forward all of that information to Visa and MasterCard for you. We do not charge for turning on credit card processing, installation, setup, training, maintenance, or support. There are very simple gateway fees that we offer from the very beginning. It's $15 across the board, no matter what your volume is. And we offer 12-hour funding, sometimes 11-hour funding. You really have to keep this in mind when you choose a processor. Many processors will guarantee next-day funding. What they really mean is 24-hour funding. As a consumer, I love to be able to call one of my vendors and talk to a live human being on the first try. This is a promise you get from American Payment Solutions. We have a dedicated support team available 24/7, 365 days a year, and you are guaranteed a live human being on the other side of the line anytime you call our support staff. We offer online management and reporting through our portal, which I will show you in a few seconds, a very streamlined installation process. It literally takes us about 10 minutes to install the software, 30 minutes to set it up, and we can train you as many times and as many people as you need. We offer a multitude of equipment options. This is free equipment, any type of credit card processing equipment, and we help set it up, maintain, and support at no charge to you. We also offer American Express Ops Blue at no charge, and the ability to process within the United States and Canada. We will soon be opening market in Latin America, Europe, Africa, and many other continents. We also help with cancellation fees. So if you're currently processing with someone and you're curious to learn how much money you can save, we will not only show you how much you can save, we will walk you through the entire switching process and help with the cancellation fees. This is what a typical analysis review would look like after we analyze your merchant statements. Now you can see that I have tiered structure, and you can see the pricing and how it varies. At the bottom, I'm showing you the bank issuer and card brand fees. This is Interchange Plus. You can see that there's a huge difference. So what we do is, through level three processing, we're able to save you an additional amount of money. And you could see, very typical, almost $17,000 a year in this particular case. So if you're interested in Acumatica, if you're a prospect, or if you're interested in any of the third-party products that are being presented today, allow us to analyze your merchant statements, and we could save you enough money to buy the third-party enhancement of your choice today. So now let's jump into Acumatica and show you how easy it is to process transactions within Acumatica. What you see on the screen is the area in which you can actually set up credit cards in Acumatica. It would be under Finance, Accounts Receivable, Customer Payment Methods. You can add as many credit cards under a customer as you need. And what will happen once you add the credit card information, we will tokenize it and store it in our secure vault. You can see the last four digits or three digits of the card, and you will notice the billing address will be available for you. You can also have a CVV code included. If you prefer to pre-authorize transactions, you can set up a default so that every time a transaction is being processed, you can pre-authorize instead of just capture. But you have both options. You can pre-authorize or capture right at the sales order level. And typically what will happen with the pre-authorization, most processors will have the pre-authorization expire within 7 days. With American Payment Solutions, the pre-authorization can last up to 30 days. Yes, you heard correctly, 30 days. You do not have to re-pre-authorize every 7 days. Now, what I did is I created a sales order, and I wanted to go straight into the payment settings. Once you choose a credit card as a default, it will auto-populate for you. Otherwise, based on the security settings that we follow as far as Acumatica's guidelines, you won't have to reset any of the security settings. The user will have access to a list so that they can pick and choose what type of credit card they'd like to use. Also available are ACH payments. Now, they're entirely optional, so you can turn this functionality on or off. Now, let's just assume that we're going to choose an American Express for now. We will autofill, as I mentioned before, the credit card information for you, so you don't have to rekey it in. Now, since we are following Acumatica security settings, the user will be permitted to edit, delete, or add a new card on the fly right within the sales order level. In this case, you're giving the user permission to pre-authorize or capture, so it's entirely up to you. If I go to pre-authorize, the transaction will actually go through our gateway. We will verify the information you provided is valid. If it is not, we will show you something like what you saw here, an invalid transaction. And part of the security settings will be that you will get a pop-up window indicating exactly what was not correct, whether it was the credit card information, the CVV code, etc. Now, as a user, you have the option to choose when you initially set up the system. If you would like to stop the user in the tracks, make them go back and correct the information, or simply click OK and continue. From this point forward, you follow Acumatica's standard process as far as invoicing, and you're able to invoice without having to do anything different. Now, when the transaction is processed, you're able to see the transaction within the APS portal or the vault. And let me just log into it really quick here. What you see on the screen right now is APS Pays. You can also process transactions directly from our portal. And you'll notice that if you do decide to process a transaction, you'll have to key in all of the relevant information. Whereas if you process within Acumatica, all of that information is pre-filled for you. We have a very robust reporting functionality with an immense amount of sorting criteria. Our project managers will also set you up to auto-batch each night. And if you batch up by 9 p.m. Eastern time, you will have the funds available in your bank account the next morning by 8 a.m. You'll notice that in the different reports, we will show you a bird's eye view of the transaction. We're going to reference the order number from Acumatica or the invoice number, depending on what you process. You can pre-authorize, and you'll notice this is a card authorization pending capture. We have an authorization in progress, and we also have approved a card sale that was directly captured at the sales order level. The transaction ID that I mentioned earlier is generated by our portal, will be populated in Acumatica for you, and you can cross-reference at any time using this transaction ID. It's an excellent means to cross-reference when you have a return or a refund. Notice the information that we will populate on our screen through Acumatica. We will take all the information from Acumatica and place it here, down to the line level detail of the invoice. All of this information is actually sent to Visa and MasterCard on your behalf instantly when you process the transaction. So really, that is all I had for Acumatica. I'm going to go ahead and hand it back over to you, Adrian.
Thank you, Patty, for that. I do have a poll I'd like to launch for the audience, and we have several questions. So I'm going to go ahead and launch this poll. So if you could just take a second to answer this question, that'd be awesome. Are you interested in learning more about any of the following? and you can check all that apply. So the Acumatica Partner Program, if you're new to Acumatica and you'd like to investigate, explore your options as far as a partner program is concerned, we'd like to hear about that. Intelligent Data Capture for Acumatica by Artsel. If you're interested in the integrated pick pack automation, shipping, or credit card processing that we just showed you, we'd love to hear about it. And let me take a look at the questions here. Thank you, James, for your question. Does Starship have integration with Saja and R&L? Caroline? And I think that you might be on mute, Caroline. Let's see. I'm going to make you an organizer. Does that help? Are you there, Caroline? Okay, I'm going to table that question until we can hear from Caroline. It looks like she might be having an issue with her audio. James has another question for you, Patty. Is development on the e-commerce bridge for APS complete? We want to do pre-authorization of credit cards on our website and final processing in Acumatica.
I do know that we have several e-commerce solutions that we currently integrate with. If you'd like, we should have a call after the webinar, and I'll bring our developers on the line so that they can provide you with an update.
And then Rick has a question. Can we get all the PowerPoint slides? Yes, Rick. I will be sending the PowerPoint slides and a recording of the presentation to everyone who registered and attended the webinar. So that'll have complete contact information for each of the presenters as well. And Caroline, did we get back connected?
Yes. Sorry about that, Adrian.
Oh, no problem.
Technical difficulties.
And Jeff assisted us with your question. Jeff was helping answer your question. Thank you, Jeff.
Thanks, Jeff.
He says, yes, Starship does have an integration with R&L, but the first part of the question was, does it have an integration with Saya?
Saya, yes. Yes, we support both Saya and R&L, and we connect directly to the carrier's servers to access your negotiated rates and get pro numbers, that kind of stuff. So I can connect up with you after the webinar to give you some more information on that, James.
And Dawn, I understand that Acumatica is a channel-only partner-driven as far as sales is concerned. Do you offer co-op dollars to help partners market Acumatica? Can you explain more about how that works?
Absolutely, happy to. So yes, first let me confirm, this is one of the great things about working with Acumatica as a partner. We only sell through partners, so we don't do anything direct. We'll never compete with you. It's a really nice channel-centric program. And as far as co-op goes, yes, we do. So we do offer co-op, and interestingly, it's not as formal as some other co-op programs that you might be used to. So it's not like you first have to place an order with Acumatica and like 1 or 2% will go in some co-op bucket. Right from the minute that you're eligible to receive co-op funding, which has to do with the certifications and so forth that you've received, but once you're eligible, it's really as easy as completing a form, a one-page form that says, what are you planning on doing? What's the cost? What's your experience been? And then usually what we do is we just fund it 50-50. That's how it typically goes. And we also, I should mention this, we also offer monthly marketing webinars so your marketing people can attend and gather all sorts of great marketing tips and tricks from our team as well.
Yeah, thank you for that, Dawn. Bosco, we have a question for Artsel. Is there a way to consolidate all incoming documents, sales orders, purchase orders, any manual related document to achieve order visibility and status, like through a dashboard?
Yes, there is. So currently what we have the ability to grab any any incoming documents and batch them together, we have something called a monitoring station, whereby all these documents can be reviewed either through a thick client or a web-based client, which I believe is referenced to a dashboard. These can be queued and then processed manually or automatically. I hope that answers the question.
And if you need any more information on that, I'm sure Bosco will get back in touch with you or a member of his team. And we have a question for you, Richard, for ScanCo. You mentioned you have a manufacturing solution integrated with JAMS. Can you elaborate in that regard?
That's right. We have a whole another product for JAMS. It's called ScanCo XScan for Acumatica. And it basically lets you take all of those principal transactions that you would do in JAMS and bring them out of the computer and onto the handheld. So it'll do your labor tracking, material issues, production entry, and so forth. And like the, and I didn't mention this before, but both apps are for iOS and Android handhelds. As long as you got a physical barcode scanner, you can use pretty much any iOS or Android device that's current. We do not support the legacy Windows mobile devices for that, for Acumatica.
And just a question for me, my curiosity, Richard, do you work independent of JAMS as well for manufacturing, or do you have to have the JAMS solution?
You have to have JAMS. So Acumatica XScan is to JAMS as Acumatica Warehouse is to the distribution module. It is strictly the barcoding and data collection module that basically takes it from Acumatica and locked in the computer and lets you bring it live onto the shop floor or warehouse floor and handheld.
Perfect. And I'm seeing that 44% of you have voted out there in the audience. If we could get more of you just to let us know what you might be interested in, that would be great. And it looks like we have 3 minutes to spare. Don, would you like to, I know that you have a hard stop coming up here. Would you like to offer any closing remarks?
I sure would. I wanted to thank, first of all, Bosco, Richard, Caroline, and Patty. Great presentation. Thank you. Certainly, Adrian, thank you for arranging for this. It's always great when our partners and prospects and end users can really see the extended power of Acumatica with our ISV solution. So thank you for that. We appreciate the questions, and we'll look forward to following up with everybody. And again, I know Adrian is going to display our contact information at the end, so you'll have that. Welcome any questions, comments, and interest that you care to send to me. I'm very much looking forward to hearing from you. So thanks again, everyone.
Thank you, Don, so much.
Thank you.
And then I'm flashing up the contact information, and let me hide these results here so that you can see it. And let me make myself presenter. Another step. There we go. There's the contact information, and you will receive this via email in addition as well. And again, thank you, Caroline, Bosco, Patty, Richard. If you guys have any closing remarks, we can go ahead and start with Richard. Richard.
No, thanks for everybody for being on the demo. Feel free to reach out if there's anything else that you want to see on either the warehouse or manufacturing side. The Acumatica business is growing real strong for us, and we're signing up new partners every day.
And Patty, would you like to offer any closing remarks?
Only to thank everybody again for allowing us to present and to remind everyone that we will be attending the Acumatica Roadshow. Everyone that's on presenting today will be there, and we'd be happy to do one-on-one presentations at American Payment Solutions. Stop by our table, number 205. We will be right beside Starship, ScanCo, and we hope to see everybody there.
Thank you for that. That's a good reminder, Patty, that Acumatica is having a nationwide road show in several different cities. So check that out if you're interested in attending. And Caroline, did you have any closing remarks? We might have lost audio again with Caroline. Bosco, we'll go ahead and close it out with you.
Yeah, thanks everyone for your attendance. I just wanted to mention that we at ArtSale do not sell direct. We sell through our partner community. So we welcome new partners, and you know, we promise you that the margins are great, and we do all the, you know, all the work for you. So if you're interested, please do reach out to us. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Oh, and Bosco, we do have one final question for you, if you have a second, just to remain on the line, from Brian. He has a question for Artzel. If he has multiple POs from the same customer, let's say four POs, can he add all four into different sales orders based on the PO number instead of one order?
Yeah, so the way our solution is configured is that we can break out documents based on different criteria. Typically, if we see one set of documents with multiple POs, we break it out by PO number. Alternatively, we can also create a rule that says these POs came all together, extract them separately, but process them as one document. I'd be happy to entertain that question directly as well. So please reach out to me if you want further clarification. Thank you.
And Bosco, Brian's question will be aligned to his name on the registration report, so you can easily reach out to him to further clarify. And just thank you, everybody, so much for taking an hour out of your day to join us. We know that your time is hard to come by, so we really appreciate you spending it with us. And thank you so much. We hope to see you on our future webinar. Take care.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.
Bye.